Hey learners, welcome to NAC Graphics. In this detailed course on how to work with Adobe Illustrator, the first topic we have been discussing is the shape tools. We have discussed the rectangle tool, rounded rectangle tool, ellipse tool, and the polygon tool in the last four lessons. Links to all these lessons are available in the description of this video in case you have missed any of them. In this lesson, we are going to talk about the star tool. But first of all, come to this view menu and hide the bounding box in case it is enabled. Long press this rectangle tool button and you've got the star tool here. Now star tool helps you draw star shape, or you may say a shape having spikes coming out of it. Now as you're seeing when I'm drawing this shape, it contains 5 number of spikes as default, but you can control the number of spikes that you want in your star. You just have to press up or down arrow keys on the keyboard to increase or decrease the number of spikes of the star. But remember that it will work only when you're still drawing the shape. That means you have not released the mouse button yet. Now you can perform various functions with the help of Shift, Alt, and Control keys while you're drawing the shape. Pressing Shift key while drawing will make an upright star with its one spike pointing upwards. See, here I'm drawing this five-sided star, and as I press the Shift key, shape is constrained upright with this spike in upright position. Now you will notice as you start drawing, the size of the star changes with the movement of your drag. Size of the whole star starts increasing when you drag outwards, and the shape contracts as you drag it inwards. Here pressing Control key locks this inner radius of the star. Now only the size of these spikes will get increased or decreased when you drag it inwards or outwards, and this inner circle maintains its position. Pressing Alt key while dragging will give you a straight alignment of the spikes. Let me tell you what that means. See here. I'm drawing this five-sided star here. As I press the Alt key, all these opposite spikes of this shape get perfectly aligned in a straight line. You can press the space bar while drawing and you can drag this shape to anywhere on the artboard. Okay. Now I've been drawing these shapes randomly, but you can draw this shape by putting in precise values too. Just click once on the artboard. Let me quickly enter some random values here and then I'll tell you what these values mean. Now see. This radius 1 is the distance of this outermost edge of the spike from the center of the shape. Radius 2 is the distance of this inner corner of the spike from its center. And here you can put in the number of spikes that you want in your star. So, this was all about the star tool. In the next lesson, we'll end up this topic of shape tools with the discussion on flare tool. Keep practicing and post your queries. We'll be more than happy to help. Thanks for watching NAC Graphics. Stay well.